We all know engineering is the best, and okay, yes, I'm biased. But we also know that it comes with its fair share of challenges. And today, I'm gonna break them down for you. Here are four common problems that engineering students face and how to solve them. You know that feeling when you're in a lecture and the lecturer's just speaking and it's just noise? Or when you're studying and you're just rereading the same word over and over and just nothing is going in? Well, if there's an engineering concept that you're struggling with, just log online and watch videos. And no, not cat videos. Just go to it.tv or even YouTube, and there are loads and loads of engineering videos that might just help explain subjects or concepts that you might be struggling with. If you type in the concept, the search engine will look for what you meant in the video transcripts and come up with the relevant results. You can even navigate to the right part of the video that you need. Engineering is not like a lot of other degrees. You're heading out to your 9-to-5 lectures while your housemates are still in their pajamas. And on top of that, there's all the other things that students have to deal with. Exams, money worries, moving house every year. It's just a lot to deal with. If you're getting stressed, don't hide it. Talk to your family, your friends, your advisors at university. And if it's getting really bad, try calling the IET's Benevolent Fund. It's a free service for all IET members that can help you when you're trying to cope with stuff like exam stress, dealing with extra funding, or even just like your lazy landlord who's trying to say stuff like, yeah, just paint over the mold. For most students, getting a graduate job is the end goal. But let's face it, you're competing with your classmates. There are a few things you can do to give you the advantage. Firstly, try talking to some people in the industry. You never know where a conversation might lead you, and they might have some tips on getting graduate jobs in a company. Try joining your university's engineering society or your IET on campus group. They actually quite often hold events for engineering and students to come together and talk. And of course, you could try other sophisticated techniques like Google. You could try generic job boards, or you can try engineering specific ones like E&T jobs. An engineering degree teaches you the theory and some soft skills like working in teams. But quite often, employers are looking for a bit more than that. So here are just a few things that you can do to add to your CV to just give you that little extra something to impress employers. Get involved in the IET's Present Around the World competition, where you present your ideas to a technical audience. It's great if you can see yourself as an entrepreneur, and it'll help you when you're presenting your ideas to a future audience. And another thing you can do is volunteer with the IET. You can do things from going into schools and meeting kids and getting them really excited about engineering, or you can help put on local events and meet other local engineers. It's a really great way to learn things that you won't learn in a lecture theater and meet other engineers at all stages and ages of their career. One last thing. Before you graduate, make sure that you sign up for the IET's Early Career Membership Package. It'll really help you when you're settling into a career and give you ideas of how you want to develop your career in the future. It's also really useful if you are one day dreaming of becoming a chartered engineer. Sorry. Drifted off. So there you have it, four engineering student problems solved. If you're interested in any of the activities or resources that I mentioned, just check them out on the Student Hub on the website. Now, sorry, if you excuse me, I need to go to a lecture.